Today we'll discuss a new topic, that is signal bandwidth as well as system bandwidth. Okay, so you often heard about bandwidth. So what is called bandwidth in signal or systems? Okay, so topic signal bandwidth. Bandwidth means a range of frequency. Okay, signal bandwidth means a signal may have one frequency, two frequency, three frequency. Okay, multi-tone frequency. So the signal bandwidth can be calculated by subtracting from highest frequency minus lowest frequency. Okay, by difference, the difference between highest and lowest frequency is called the signal bandwidth. Okay. Signal bandwidth means what are the frequency range present in the signal is called by signal bandwidth, as well as what is system bandwidth. The system bandwidth is called the frequencies which are allowed by the systems is called system bandwidth. Okay, so another thing you should remember that in a frequency domain, if you see the Fourier transform, okay, we anytime write in both left and right side. Okay, and suppose this is a response of a signal in frequency domain. So suppose this is omega 1, this is omega 2, this is minus omega 1, this is minus omega 2. So here you can see this is the lowest frequency you can say present in the signal, this is the highest frequency present in the signal. So as well as in the lower side also there have frequency. Okay, but to calculate the frequency bandwidth, okay, signal bandwidth or system bandwidth, what will take, we will take only the positive side. Okay, because in the practical scenarios or in the real time, we will not deal with anything with the negative frequency. There is nothing called negative frequency like minus 50 hertz or minus 100 hertz. This is only for theoretical purpose, because this has come only for the equation of Fourier transform. So to calculate the positive signal bandwidth, we'll take only the positive positive side. So in this case, bandwidth is nothing but W2 minus W1. Okay, W2 minus W1 for this diagram, because this is the highest frequency is omega 2, lowest frequency is omega 1, and we have to take only positive sides. Okay, so if you want to write this definition, you can write that it is the range of positive frequencies. Okay, I have write positive because we'll only consider in the positive duration or positive side. Okay, so it is the range of positive frequencies where the signal energy exists or lies. You can write exist where the signal energy exists or lies. Okay, but there has some finite below of energy. So it is the range of positive frequency where the signal energy exists. Okay, so how we can calculate the signal bandwidth? Signal bandwidth is calculated by subtracting highest frequency minus lowest frequency. Okay. So in this example, what is the highest frequency? In the plot, highest frequency is omega 2. What is the lowest frequency in the plot? It is omega 1. So the bandwidth would be omega 2 minus omega 1. Okay, this is, and if you are writing the frequency bandwidth in terms of omega, then you have to write what? Radian by second. Okay, so another thing is that based on the bandwidth calculation, okay, the signal is categorized in different means different term or different category is there. One is band limited and another is non-band limited. Let me write what I want to say. I think you have completed writing. Let me write in the next place. So far, what I have said, based on the bandwidth calculation, okay? Bandwidth calculation. Signal can be categorized, okay? Can be divided as, suppose this is the signal, can be divided as two types. Okay, one is band limited, and other is non band limited. One is band limited, other one is non band limited. Okay. So again, this band limited is categorized in two types. One is baseband. Baseband, this term you should remember, what is called baseband, or what is another is band pass. What is called band pass. Okay. This time you will often heard about in the communication system or in the signal processing like subject. Okay. This baseband also known as low pass signal, okay, low pass baseband signal or low pass, and this is a band pass. Okay, so all the categories is done based on the frequency, okay. The frequency where it is start, whether it is start from zero or not, based on that the this category has come into the picture. So I will explain one by one each of this term, okay, what is called band limited and what is called non-band limited. So let me know if you finished, okay. Initially, I will explain this band limited, okay. Then I will give example of each of this band limit band pass shape, okay, in the frequency domain. And this category is done only the starting point of frequency, that you should remember what is called band limited, and by name itself you should able to guess, okay. Signal band limited means, and what is non-band limited means. Band limited means the maximum frequency in the signal are finite. That is the band limited. And non-band limited means the maximum frequency present in the signals is unknown. Or you can say that is infinity, okay? Unknown or infinity, then it is called a non-band limited. So let me give the means example in the next page. So here, baseband or low pass signal are those signal starting point is at zero. Okay, you can write that at the note. You can write at a point that starting frequency class here, take the attendance. You know what I have written? Starting starting frequency at zero, and baseband. It is the it is on under the one category under the band limited signal. Okay, and I have said band limited means the maximum frequency present in the signal is finite. Okay, so and it is and I have written here that starting frequency is zero. If you when I plot, then you able to understand. In a frequency domain, suppose this is a x of omega, let me write in modulus, and this is omega. Okay, starting frequency at zero means any frequency which exists at zero zero also, then this is called a baseband signal. Okay, suppose this is omega m, this is minus omega m. Okay, so I think you are able to understand. Band limited means the maximum frequency is finite. Baseband or low pass filter signal means baseband or low pass signal means it start at zero, means starting frequency at zero. Okay, or frequency component present at zero also. Okay, so this is called baseband signal. So what is the bandwidth of this signal, or what is the bandwidth this x of omega? The bandwidth is what is highest frequency. What is the highest frequency in this graph or in this plot? Highest frequency is omega m. You should speak, okay? Otherwise, I cannot say whether you are able to understand or not. So bandwidth is highest frequency is omega m, and what is the lowest frequency? And we have to see the positive side only, okay? So in the positive side, highest frequency is omega m, lowest frequency is zero. So bandwidth is omega m, and we have to write radian per second. Okay. So come to the second term, second type of signal based on the bandwidth, that is band pass. One is baseband, another is band pass. Band pass signal. Okay. The difference you should know. So bandpass means bandpass. This signal also a band limited. Band limited means the signal, the highest frequency present in the signal should be finite. But what is the difference? Here starting frequency is at zero, but here in this starting frequency. Is not at zero. Understand? When I plot, then you are able to understand. Here, starting frequency is not at zero. Okay. Suppose this is also x of omega. Okay, and it starts from here and ending at here. Okay. Suppose start at omega one and ending at omega two, because here maximum frequency is finite. Okay, so it is not a band limited signal. It is a band limited signal because maximum frequency present in the signal is finite. So at the left hand side also, we have to plot, because we are trying to plot in frequency domain or Fourier transform. This is minus omega two. This is minus omega one. Okay, so you can see here it is not start from zero. There is no frequency component present at omega equal to zero. So this is not a low pass signal or a baseband signal, it is a band pass signal. So what is the bandwidth in this case? Bandwidth of the signal, it is highest frequency is omega 2, lowest frequency is omega 1. Okay, so this is the bandwidth. We have to write radian per second because it is written in omega. So let me know if you finished. I'll proceed to the next page to explain about non-band limited signal. Come to the second type of signal, that is non-band limited signal. Okay, non-band limited signal. By name itself, you can able to guess what is the signal. This is a signal whose highest frequency is infinity. Okay, non-band limited. So here also two types is there. One is baseband or low pass. Baseband or low pass signal is there. Okay. So in this case, point is what? Starting frequency. Is at zero, isn't it? So how will be the plot? It start from zero, but frequency is not ending. It is going up to infinity. So how will be the plot? Let me plot a signal characteristics of this kind of types. This is okay. This is like, suppose this is a frequency representation of x of omega, where it starting frequency is at omega equal to zero. But there is no highest frequency we can say, okay? We cannot say what is the highest frequency. So we should say it is frequency present up to infinity. Okay? So what is the bandwidth of this signal? Can anybody say? So what is the bandwidth? Somebody will say that it is infinity minus zero. Okay, infinity. It is not infinity. If this type of shape is there, okay, then maximum information will lies below near to the zero. Okay, omega equal to zero. As you go further, there will be the less information. So what will take? We'll take a criteria. Okay. We will take a criteria such that we can take the means major information. That criteria is that we have to take a frequency term or a point where this amplitude will be a 1/√2 times. Understand? 1/√2 times means 0.7077. At that point, if you take a horizontal line, then where it's cut at the frequency domain, that is called omega c. Okay, new term has come. This is omega c. And what is called omega c? This is the cut of frequency. This is the cut-off frequency of this shape of signal. Okay, so this bandwidth has a special name. This is called 3 dB bandwidth or half power bandwidth. Okay, so now what is the bandwidth? Then bandwidth is highest frequency will take as a omega c and lowest frequency is zero. Okay, so this bandwidth has a special name, that is called 3 dB bandwidth, or it is also known as half power bandwidth. So it's equal to how much highest frequency is omega c, we have to think, and lowest frequency is zero, and this is omega c. Okay, so why it is called 3 dB? Can you answer it, why it is called 3 dB? Anything if you want to write in the dB, what will take? We have to take 20 log of that quantity, okay? Then that is called dB. So when you take this amplitude root 2, and if you find log 20, then it will give you a value of 3, okay? And this minus 3 dB is this 3 is called as dB, okay? This quantity is written in terms of new term dB, okay? So that's why this is called 3 dB bandwidth or a half hour bandwidth. Why it is called half hour bandwidth? Because at this point, okay, at omega c, if you calculate the power, then power will be the 50% when you calculate the power for the whole signal. That's why it is called a half hour also, half hour bandwidth. So is it clear? So another shape is there under this types baseband signal. Another shape is there. And write both the shape. This is different in the non-band limited signal. So another signal, suppose this is. This is another signal. It is nothing but sine function. If you take modulus, it is become like this. Okay. So in this case also, it is going up to infinity. In this case also, you can say that the signal starting frequency is there. Means at omega equal to zero, there has some value. So it is fall under baseband signal. As well as the signal has infinite frequencies. That's why it is called as non-band limited signal, isn't it? So it is called a non-band limited signal. But what is the bandwidth? What is the bandwidth of such type of signal? Suppose this is, you can write as omega 1, this is omega 2, this is omega 3, like that. Omega 1, omega 2, omega 3, like that, okay? Then what is the bandwidth for this signal? Can anybody say? Bandwidth of the signal is? So another important information you should know, this bigger shape is known as major loop, okay, and this smaller are known as a side loop, okay, minor loop or side loop. So and major loop contains most of the information of this signal. So what will take the bandwidth, consider up to omega 1, okay, the main cutoff frequency here will take as a omega 1. So for this signal, for this shape, the bandwidth will consider as highest frequency as omega 1 and lowest frequency is 0. And it is given as omega 1. So this thing you should know. So next one is left, that is called bandpass signal. Can I proceed to next page?
Yes, sir. Come here.
So next type is band pass. Okay. In the previous one is baseband. Baseband means starting frequency can be seen at omega equal to zero. Band pass signal. Okay. Bandpass means, you can write here, starting frequency is not at zero. Okay, so how will be the shape? Here also there is two type, and not it is under that. Here what is the concept? We are discussing non-band limited. Non-band limited means highest frequency is infinity, and band pass means the starting point is not at zero. Okay, then how will be the shape? Suppose I will take the second shape. Okay, second shape is like this. So it is going up to infinity. This is going up to infinity, and here also at the left side also there will be similar shape. We are not see the negative side. Okay, we are looking only at positive side only, because for calculating the bandwidth we will see the positive frequency only. Suppose this is omega 1, this is omega 2, like this omega 3, omega 4, but we will see only the major loop. Okay, we'll see only the major loop. So in this case, what will be the, this is the band pass, because it is not, it start at omega equal to zero. Okay, so what is the bandwidth for this case? Bandwidth, I have said most of the information is occupied by this major loop. So bandwidth will be omega 2 minus omega 1. Okay, so these concepts should be clear. Okay, the only difference is that in a non-band limited signal you have to give some more idea. You should have some more idea about 3 dB bandwidth, half power bandwidth, or taking the for calculating the bandwidth you should know what is major loop, what are minor loop. Okay, the bandwidth are only consider the major loop. Okay, for the previous shape I've said, for such type of shape you have to know the 3 dB bandwidth calculation. Okay, so the signal bandwidth, I think you have understand that the frequency component present in the signal, okay, or range of frequency component present in the signals are called signal bandwidth. Okay, and what will be the system bandwidth? System bandwidth is defined as, you can say that it is the range of frequency which is allowed by the system, is called as system bandwidth. Okay, let me write the definition here. System bandwidth. System means this LTS system, you can think of the signal, a band signal is come, or multitone signal is come input to the system. Then if the system cannot pass all the frequencies which are present to the signal, then you are not getting the desired output. Okay, so you should have the knowledge. You should have knowledge of both signal as well as systems. Okay, if a system allow only the 100 hertz, okay, let me say, if a system allow only the 100 hertz frequency and you are applying input multitone signal, then you will not get the desired output as you want. Okay, so system bandwidth also you should know. So the definition of what I am saying, the system bandwidth is the frequency range allowed by the system. Okay, it is the range of, you can write the definition, it is the range of frequencies which are allowed by the system is called system bandwidth. Okay, it is the range of frequencies which are allowed by the system is called bandwidth. So for a proper communication, okay, for a proper communication, what should requirement? System bandwidth okay should be very very greater than signal bandwidth. You can write okay, signal bandwidth, or you can write signals highest frequency component. Okay, this is the requirement for a proper communication, that system bandwidth should be very very high as compared to the signal bandwidth or signal maximum frequency present in the signal. So only 1 minute left.